So let us get started with our NumPy exercise. We can import NumPy to the current notebook or the current Python program using the command import NumPy. So usually we import in the fashion import NumPy as np. Okay, so we use short form of NumPy everywhere. Now we know that NumPy is the fundamental library for very useful data structures in the scientific Python ecosystem. And one of the most important data structure that we are going to see now is NDArray. NDArray stands for N-dimensional array. So let us try to create a simple one-dimensional NDArray. Okay, so NDArray could have multiple dimensions, but only to get started, we will create a simple one-dimensional NDArray. So I'm going to say x equals to np dot array. So just pay attention to the syntax that I am typing in, 1, 2, 3. So this is a list, and np dot int 16. So 16-bit integer is the data type of this, of the elements within this NDArray, and this is a one-dimensional NDArray. So I will just go ahead and execute this entire section or this entire cell, and it has created the array. So if I want to see the values of entire array, I will just say printx, and if I want to know the type or the data type of this element x or this variable x, I will just say, this is a classic trick in Python programming language. You have this function known as type. It is a very useful function. It actually shows you what class that variable or the object belongs to. So if I execute this, it shows me first, or it first prints the NDArray 1, 2, 3, and it says that the class of this element is nothing but numpy.ndarray. So this is how we can define a simple one-dimensional NDArray. So we can easily extend this entire philosophy to 2 dimensions, 3 dimensions, and multiple dimensions. Okay, so before we move ahead, we will just see how we can address individual elements in this array. Okay, in this single dimension array. So it is just like we address the elements in a list. So we can just say x of 0. So this follows actually the C style indexing, and the indexing starts from 0 and print of x of 1 and print x of x comma 2. So this is going to show us all the elements in this NDArray. So if I execute run, it shows me 1, 2 and 3 in different lines, because we are addressing each and every element individually. So earlier it was actually enclosed, everything was enclosed in a pair of square brackets because we were printing the entire NDArray. Now if I run something like print x minus 1 or print x 3, so we should get some sort of out of bound exception. So if I execute entire cell, okay, so I am able to see the out of bound exception. Okay, here print x minus 1, it means print the last element of the NDArray. Okay, but when I say print x of 3, then I get index 3 is out of bound for axis 0 with size 3. So it means that the size does not match and we have addressed the wrong element or the element which does not exist. So usually in most of the modern programming languages like Java and Python, it is out of bound exception. So suppose n is the array is the size of your array, or n is the size of your list, or any list-like data structure, and you are trying to address kth element where k is greater than n, then usually we encounter this sort of error, out of bound exception or out of bound error. So this is about indexing and addressing the elements of a single dimensional ND array. Now we are going to move towards a bit more complex stuff. We are going to move towards two-dimensional ND array. Now it is very easy. We just need to add another dimension to this. So this itself makes it a two-dimensional array, but we want to have the real data. We will just say 4, 5, and 6. So if I execute this, so before going for further, we will just print the value so that we should see the creation of object as well as printing the value of object in a single cell. So if I run this, I can see that it's a two-dimensional data structure. It's a two-dimensional ND array. I can address the element of this in the following fashion. It is again C style indexing scheme, 0, 0, and we can extend the same thing to 0, 1 and 0, 2. So if I execute this entire cell, I should be able to see 1, 2 and 3. So this is the first row and first column, first row, second column, first row and third column. Now there is something that we need to know about slicing operation. So slicing is, you know, the loaf of bread, right? So when I say I want to slice a loaf of bread, then I can actually either slice it horizontally or vertically. Basically, a loaf of bread is a three-dimensional structure, but only to have a real life example, you can actually slice the loaf of bread along three axes, okay, three different axes. Similarly, if there is a simple square page, okay, or a two-dimensional data structure, you can slice that data structure around two axes. So let us say now how to slice this particular ND array. So the way to slice it is print. See, the slicing operation is even possible in C, C++ and Java, but we have to write a single or multiple for loops in order to achieve this slicing. But here in Python, without any sort of for loop, you will be able to achieve this slicing with the trick employed by the Python programming language. So pay attention now. So if I just say colon, comma, 0, and if I execute this, let us see the fun. Okay, sorry, I just had to say x. Okay, so earlier syntax was wrong, and if I say run, okay, so the colon comma 1 is 1, 4. It means that it is printing the first column. If I want to print the second column, colon comma 1, it is now going to print the second column, 2, 5, and similarly I can print the third column with this syntax. Correct. Now, did you understand the magic behind this? If you have any two-dimensional data structure in C, C++ or Java, you will have to write a loop to show the value of entire row or an entire column. But here, you really do not have to write a loop. You can just use this sort of syntax. And now if I say print x 0, colon, this is going to print the entire first row. Similarly, 1, colon, entire second row will be printed. So this is the beauty of it. This is the magic. This actually works perfectly like a clockwork. So you can just extend this logic to higher dimensions. So now this was all about slicing. Now let us have a look at a three-dimensional ND array. Because that is the highest number of dimensions in which all of us can visualize. So it is kind of very difficult to visualize anything that has more than three spatial dimensions. Okay, that is actually the limitation of human mind, but the mathematics doesn't have that sort of limitation. But still, for the purpose of our convenience and learning, we will see the three-dimensional ND array. So again, creating three-dimensional ND array is very easy task. We are just going to copy the earlier code and just going to modify that. So just pay attention how I achieve this. This, as we know, is a two-dimensional array, and let's make it a three-dimensional ND array by adding one more dimension and adding some more data to it. So these are the data points, data items. So I will just say 0, comma minus 1, comma minus 2, and minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So if I execute this means that this is a three-dimensional ND array. Now let us try to address the elements of this three-dimensional ND array. So we again have to follow the C style indexing scheme, which is 0, 0, 0. So it is going to print the first row, first column, and the first height, I would say. Okay. So it is going to print the element located at 0, 0, 0. So in my opinion, that element should be 1. So what do you say? Let us execute this code and see the output. Yes, the element is 1. Now let's print some other element. 3. Okay, so it says index 3 is out of bounds for axis 2. So I'm just going to say 2, and it should print 3. Yes. And if I say 2, 0, 2 should be, let us execute it. Okay, it is out of bounds. So I'm just going to say 1, and it is minus 2. Okay. And if I say 1, then it should be something like minus 5. Yes, it is minus 5. Now, if I want to slice this, we can slice it along three dimensions. I can say print x colon comma colon comma 0. Then let us see what it returns. It returns 1, 4, 0, -3. Okay, 1 and 4, 0, -3. So the entire first column. Similarly, if I say 1, it should return the second entire column. Similarly, we can even address two dimensions like this. Okay, it is out of bound, so I'm just going to say 1. Yes, 5, -4. So 5, -4. So this way we can slice it along one or multiple dimensions. So this was all about one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and three-dimensional ND arrays. We can keep on adding dimensions, and we can then keep on slicing, indexing the array. We can address the element of even higher dimensional data structures. So now just imagine if you have ever worked with something like C, C++, or Java. We know that multi-dimensional arrays can be created in all the programming languages, but again, you will have to write a lot of code in order to perform all these operations, and it cannot be performed so intuitively and so easily. So had we used C, C++, or Java, we would have required to write at least a few hundred lines of code in order to achieve the same results. So this is how we can create, index, and slice one-dimensional, two-dimensional, three-dimensional, and multi-dimensional ND arrays in NumPy and Python 3. So do let me know if you have any questions or queries related to the same. Thanks a lot for watching this video lecture, and I hope to see you all in the next video lecture.